Dearly beloved, we are assembled here in the presence of friends, family, and of God. Join Talita Nascimento and Martin
Melders.
We've been practicing Melders. In the holy covenant of marriage, which was instituted of God, regulated by his commandments, blessed by our Lord Jesus Christ, and to be held in honor among all men. Let us therefore reverently remember that God has established and sanctified marriage for the welfare and happiness of mankind. He has instructed those who enter into this relationship to cherish a mutual esteem and love for one another, to bear with each other's infirmities and weaknesses, and to comfort each other in sickness, trouble, and sorrow, to provide for each other and for their household in temporal things, to pray for and encourage each other in the things which pertain to God, and to live together as the heirs of the grace of life. And to this holy union, Martin and Talita now come to be joined. Who is it that gives or presents Talita to be married to Martin?
I do.
Let me pause and let's pray for this time this afternoon. Let's just give a moment of prayer. Father, we thank you for this joyous evening. We thank you for the privilege of coming and being with Martin and Talita as they make these promises and commitments and enter this covenant with you. And we pray that as we are together, that your presence would be evident, that your joy would fill this time together, and that you would put your blessing upon our time as we witness them joining their hearts and their lives together. And we ask it in the wonderful name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
First, I want to speak to you as pastor. 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 through 8 is a portion of scripture that you guys chose. And it says, love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud, it is not rude, and it is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered, and it keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. And love never fails. Talita, you will be the greatest blessing of Martin's life. You will not be trapped in our current culture with its fixation on outward beauty, which time has a way of fading, but you will continue to be his helpmate in developing the inner qualities that will enrich his life and make it a pleasure to follow the Lord's leadership for your home. And Martin, you will be the greatest blessing in Talita's life as you show her understanding and give her dignity in every circumstance of life. Always guard her as the most precious treasure you have, and God will grant you the strength and the wisdom to lead your home in God's way. And to you both, the most important relationship that you have has not changed today. Your relationship with God will always have to be center and the foundation of all others. You're entering into a covenant with one another and with God that places all other earthly relationships secondary to the one that you will now have with one another. So Martin and Talita, I want to ask you in the presence of God and these witnesses to declare your intention to unite with one another through the grace of Jesus Christ. Just as Christ declared his intention to call you into union with himself through his death and resurrection, Martin, you are entering a holy covenant with God and with Talita. You are about to take upon a solemn vow incurring happiness and lasting responsibilities. Talita, the woman of your choice, is now to become the partner of your life, the co-heir of your possessions, and the queen of your home. In no other way could she so manifest her love for you as she leaves her home ties, companionship of friends, and all those who share with her the joys, and she will share with you the joys as well as the sorrows of life. With you, she will now abide, and with you, for she will live. And Martin, I ask you, will you have Talita to be your wedded wife to live together after God's ordinances in the holiest state of matrimony? Honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for her as long as you both shall live.
I do.
Belita, you also are entering into a holy covenant with God and Martin. You are also to assume responsibilities. He whom you are about to wed will look to you for solace in the hour of trial. Your smile should be his brightest day, and your voice his sweetest music. Your lips his faithful counselor, and your prayers his most able advocate at heaven's court. Belita, will you have Martin to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinances in the holy estate of matrimony? And do you promise to love him, to comfort him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only for him as long as you both shall live? I believe you've chosen some rings to have. Where do we have the rings? The rings, please.
We have the images.
Can I get them off of there? Thank you. All right. Let us think about these symbols of the rings. The Bible tells us that when God made a covenant with Noah, he set a rainbow in the clouds as a token of that covenant and said, I will look upon it that I may remember the everlasting covenant. And from this we learn that it is well for us when we enter a holy covenant to set aside some reminder. You've selected these rings to be tokens of your marriage covenant. The ring, an endless circle until broken by some outside force, is a symbol of the unbroken union, which is to continue until broken by death. Martin, take this ring, place it on the ring finger, Felita's hand, and let it be the seal of your mutual affection, your fidelity, and a memorial of this. Repeat this pledge with me. With this ring, I thee wed.
I thee wed.
And with all earthly possession,
and with all earthly possession,
I give to you,
I give to you,
in the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
the Son,
the Son, of the Holy Spirit,
and God the Spirit. Belita, you will take this ring, place it on Martin's hand, his ring finger, and let it be a seal of your mutual fidelity, affection, and a memorial of this sacred service. And repeat this with me. With this ring,
I do
wed.
With
all earthly possession, I give to you, in the name of the Father,
and
of the Son,
and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. And now, having heard you make these pledges of these vows of fidelity, I do, by the authority conferred upon me by the Church of Jesus Christ and the laws of this state, pronounce you husband and wife, no longer two, but one. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Woo! If you'd like to come, and we got it done. We're going to pray a prayer of blessing over their lives together. Take your hands. Father, we thank you. We thank you for this joyous time and for this choice and decision that join their lives together. And as they journey through life together, Father, we pray that they will always know your presence in their home and in their lives together.
Amen.
Father, that they would fulfill the call that you have, not on them as individuals, but as a couple. That they will know the joy of following and pursuing after you with all of their hearts.
Amen.
We pray that you would give them wisdom and strength and courage to face the challenges that life will bring. We pray that you will give them the blessings of your Holy Spirit upon their lives together. We pray that you'd fill their home with laughter and with joy. That you'd fill their lives with children at the appropriate time.
Amen.
That you have a new life entering into their home and into their lives. And Father, we pray that they would just always be filled with your peace, your joy, your comfort, and most of all, that they would be filled with your love. And that they would know how to love one another and treat each other with grace and mercy and kindness. That they would always pursue you in all that they do. And Lord, we pray your divine hand on their lives, and we thank you for their testimony of faith in Christ, that they desire to follow you, and they want to be known as Christ followers. And I pray that their home would lead others to Christ. As people come into their path, they will come to know Christ as a result of this marriage and of this couple. that they would always have the things that they need, that your word says you will provide, and that they will always have provision of life for all the things that they have need of. You are their source. Keep them in that place of faith, that place of obedience, and that place of following you. And we ask your blessing in Jesus' name. Amen.
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 Make it the bride.
Get the bride.
Is that in here? Oh, it is in here. Allow me to present to you Mr. and Mrs. Martin and Milder.
Milders.
Milders. I want to say Milders all day, but Milders. Milder and Milders. Those whom God has joined, let no man or woman separate. Martin, you can kiss your bride.
Yeah. Yeah.
Congratulations. And I guess at this point we're going to hang out.
Yeah, I
Take it out. Enjoy. God bless you.
Toda papa.
Dona!